from now. Okay, one alternative tools that we can use to solve the problem of kinematics of a rigid body on a plane or planar rigid body motion is the idea of the ICZV. Maybe not every time we can use, but most of the time, if we carefully check the problem and try to imagine how can be used, we can use it, and it is very useful tools. What is the idea of the ICZV? What is the idea of ICZV? For a rigid body, and a rigid body may rotate with the combination of translation, rotate and translate in the same time. Of course, omega is the angular velocity of a rigid body. Omega is angular velocity of a rigid body. And the point ICZV, or instantaneous center of zero velocity, is the point where the velocity vector is equal to zero. Plus only at that moment, just only at that moment. So of course, we may have some problem that we have a fixed point that velocity always be zero. But in many systems, the general system, maybe we don't have a fixed point, but all the point in the system at one instant, it can be ICZV. For example, if we see in this schematic, we have a rigid body and we have point A and point B on a rigid body. Point A, if we consider the velocity at point A, we have VA. At point B, we also have VB. And there is one point. The point can be the point on the rigid body or a point that far away from the rigid body. Don't need to be on the body. It can be any point anywhere on the plane. And at that point, the velocity is zero. So what is the benefit if we know that at point C, the velocity is zero? The velocity vector of A with respect to the point C is the length of AC, multiplied by the omega of the rigid body. If point C velocity as of is zero, the velocity of A with respect to C is the length multiplied by omega, and the distance is normal to the line CA. From this information, and we know that the velocity of point C is zero. So we can find VA. Because the VA can be written in the terms of the velocity of point C. And the relative velocity of A with respect to C. So yeah, by the concept, it's nothing. It's just we have the relative velocity. We have the relative velocity. And the reference point has zero velocity. And the relative velocity is just the radius multiplied by omega. By the concept, it's nothing. It's just only this. For the VB, yeah, VB, we also can compose VB by VC. And the relative velocity of B with respect to C. And VC is zero. And VB with respect to C, VB with respect to C is the length here multiplied by the omega of the rigid body. The omega of the rigid body is the same everywhere. Omega is everywhere. It depends on the radius. If we want to compute the velocity, omega always be the same. So how can we find the ICZV position? How to locate ICZV? How to locate the ICZV? If we have a rigid body, at point B may have a velocity vector. At point A may have a velocity vector. At point A, how to locate the ICZV? The first thing you need to do is draw a perpendicular line with the velocity vector. Draw a perpendicular line with the velocity vector at that point. At point A, you also draw a perpendicular line at point A. You have two points, A and B. At point B, you draw a perpendicular line. At point A, you draw a perpendicular line. At the intersection, at that point, the point will be the ICZV. So the first step is to draw perpendicular line. Perpendicular to V velocity vector. Perpendicular to the velocity vector. And the ICZV will be at the intersection point of the perpendicular line. How can we apply the idea? Many times in the problem, we may know the VA. For example, if we know VA, and we know the position of the ICZV. We can obtain omega of rigid body. Omega is equal to the velocity divided by the length between the ICZV and the A point, and we can have omega. And after we know omega, and we want to obtain the velocity at any position on a rigid body, we just use the omega and multiply by the distance between the ICZV point and the point that we want to obtain the velocity vector. So here, how can we apply? But we will see it in the example. There is a few things that we need to check in this two picture. What if VA and VB, what if VA and VB are parallel? What if VA and VB are parallel? The ICZV we have the perpendicular line to VA. We have perpendicular line to VB. If we use the same criteria here, the intersection point, we have infinite point of the intersection point because they have the same perpendicular line. In this case, if the velocity are parallel, we need to obtain the ICZV by the similar triangle. It means you need to draw the line that connect the magnitude of the velocity and by the profile of the magnitude of the velocity, by the profile of the magnitude of the velocity, it makes sense that at one point, it's gonna have zero velocity along the profile. So at that point, it's gonna be the ICZV. So yes, the omega is VA divided by the distance VA. And the omega is also equal to VB divided by the distance CB. How about when the velocity vector have opposite direction? So the perpendicular line, also have infinite intersection. But again, we use the similar triangle. And we have the relationship between the VA and the omega. And the relationship between the VB and the omega. And how to apply, the idea of the ICZV. Maybe to let you see the potential, we may come back to, the same problem, the same example that we just already complete in the previous example. We need to, find the omega CA of the boom. we need to find the omega CA. And we know the omega OB and know the geometry. How can we apply the idea of ICZV to this problem? So let's sketch the picture again. We have the point O and we have the point C. And O link to point B. O link to point B. And from point C, it linked to point A. Link to point A. And we also have a link. We have a link AB. We have a link AB. Okay. And we have the geometry. And do you think where is the IC sub V? Where is the IC sub V of this system? The first thing we need to do, is draw perpendicular line to the velocity vector. And the ICZV will be at the intersection point. So in this picture, do you think in which point we can predict the direction of the velocity vector? Of course, we know that at this point, we know VB. We know VB. And of course, at this point, we can find the direction of VA direction because it's perpendicular to the radial direction, the radial direction. But to find the ICZV, we need to draw the perpendicular line to the velocity vector. It means we're gonna draw this line that perpendicular to VB. And we also need to draw another perpendicular line that perpendicular to the velocity VA. It means we have something like this. And the intersection point somewhere will be the ICZV point. And yeah, our task is to take the information from the problem to obtain the geometric relationship, The VB, in this case, the VB magnitude of the velocity at point B is equal to the omega of OB and multiply by the length here. The VB is omega of the OB multiplied by the length 0.12. And yeah, we know the omega. So the VB, the magnitude is 0.06 meter per second is the velocity, the magnitude of the velocity at point B from the given information. So what should be the omega? The omega we are talking about is the omega about the IC sub V. The omega about the IC sub V should be VB divided by a distance 0.12 plus the distance OC. This distance we have 0.12 and the distance OC. The omega about the IC sub V, the omega about the IC sub V, that represent the omega of the system of the rigid body at that moment, when this have the zero velocity. Of course, the link itself has velocity. The link itself has the angular velocity. Omega OB, omega CA has different value, but because it rotate about the different point, but for the concept of the IC sub V, we consider that, hey, in the current mechanism, there is one point that has zero speed. The omega of the rigid body at that moment is the omega about the point IC sub V. So if you want to obtain that omega, we need to have the velocity and divide by the radius measure from the point B to the IC sub V. And now we still don't know the OC, but by the geometric relationship, do you think we can find OC? Do you think we can find OC? Okay, the angle here has the theta here, and the theta will be the same at here. And the distance 0.12 meter. And yeah, we know that tan of the angle, we know that tan theta is 4, 3, and 5. So yeah, by this idea, you should know that the OC, now the length of the OC, it should equal to 0.16. So that the tan of the angle is equal to 4/3. So now you know this length. You also can find this length by the relationship 3, 4, and 5. So this length will be 0.2 meter. And of course, you know 0.2, this one. Mm-hmm. And now, when you know the length OC, I think now we can find omega of the rigid body. We have 0.06 divided by 0.12 plus 0.16, and which is equal to 0.214 radian per sec. And this is the omega. So what should be VA? If we come back to here, the step by step, hey, if we know the magnitude of a velocity at one point, we find omega of rigid body by the magnitude of the velocity divided by the radius. If we know the omega, if we want to obtain the velocity at any point, we just find the product of omega and the distance between that point and the ICZV. So the step by step, we know the velocity magnitude at point B. We obtain the omega. The next is, what should be the magnitude of velocity at point A? So the magnitude of velocity at point A is equal to the omega of the rigid body and multiply by the radius, the distance between the Z and the A point. This distance, so that we can get the VA. So the distance will be 0.2 plus 0.2. And the omega is 0.214. So VA, the magnitude of velocity, is 0.08, try to check this again. And what's next? What do we need to find? Now we know the velocity, the magnitude of velocity, but the omega that we need to know is not the omega of the whole system. It's the omega of just a link CA. Omega of just a link CA. So we cannot take the full radius CA. We cannot take the radius this. But if we want to find the omega CA, we're gonna use the velocity at point A and divide by the length CA. This length is CA. But the omega of CA is VA divided by the length CA. So it's 0.2. So for the velocity analysis, in the step of the velocity, we can apply the idea of the ICZV. We can apply the idea of the ICZV so that we can get the answer. We don't need to, it's an alternative method. But the limitation is, if sometimes we need to use the ICZV method so that we can simply get the information for the omega. But finally, if we need to go into the acceleration, we still need to continue with the conventional method, the relative motion method. The limitation of ICZV is that we can use only in the step of the velocity, but we cannot use it for the acceleration because the idea is generate from the consideration, the kinematic consideration of the velocity vector only, not the acceleration. So now you know you today you see two methods to solve the same problem. The relative motion, by consider the velocity vector relationship, and by using the application of the ICZV. Okay, this problem, we gonna continue with the ICZV for this problem and try with the relative motion method. Try with the ICZV first for this problem. In this problem, the actuator is this one. The actuator is this one. And it tries to move in the horizontal direction. It moves in the horizontal direction. And for example, when it moved to the right hand side, what happened is that the point D will move downward along the slot. And of course, when point D moves downward, at this point, it's gonna have the velocity in the upward direction also. And if this move to the right hand side and point D move downward, it's gonna have the velocity to the right hand side also, and the plunger with the complete spring will move to the right hand side. Okay, read the problem together. We have the horizontal oscillation of the spring load plunger E. The spring load plunger E. It means the spring is already compressed. The spring is compressed by this position. And we have a roller that have the contact with the surface of the plunger. And by motion of the roller, the plunger can move horizontally. But in this case, we want the plunger to have the horizontal oscillation. It means it have the cycle movement to the left, to the right. And how can we control it to have the horizontal oscillation? We have a horizontal pneumatic cylinder, this one. And the information given here, they just said that the plunger has the velocity of 2 meters per second to the right. So it means the have 2 meters per second to the right. So the plunger has velocity of 2 meters per second to the right. For the plunger itself, it has the pure horizontal motion, but it induces the motion of the roller here. As it's preload, it means that the surface of the roller always in contact with the surface, the top surface of the plunger, which means this information, 2 meters per second, is the velocity of point A, just in the horizontal direction. The velocity of point A in the horizontal X direction is given. if we need to apply the idea of the ICSFV to this, the first thing we need to do, again, we know the velocity vector of this one. The plunger E, is going to the right-hand side, Can you imagine at point D is going upward or downward? If point E is moving to the right, yeah, we may can predict that the point E, point D has velocity vector in the downward direction. We may can predict that. And how about this point? Do you think point B, what is the direction of the motion of point D, Of course, the point B can have the motion, the velocity, only in the horizontal direction. But we don't know if go to the left or to the right-hand side at this time. But the velocity of point B should be in the horizontal direction. So, of course, we know the line of motion, but we still cannot confirm the direction of motion if we don't have much experience. Let's see, can we find the ICZV if we don't have much experience? At least we know that, the velocity of point D is in vertical direction. So if we draw a perpendicular line, it will be like this. For point B, it moves in the horizontal direction, but we may cannot confirm whether it's going to the left or to the right because we don't have much experience, but at least we know that it moves in the horizontal direction. If we draw a perpendicular line to the velocity, we can have one intersection point here, And yes, at this point is ICZV. And it have the zero velocity at one moment. It has zero velocity at one moment. This angle is theta. This angle also have the theta angle. And we have the dimension here. And the angle is 30 degree. So if this is 200, psi 30 degree is 0.5. So this length should be 100 millimeter. Because psi 30 degree is 1/2. What should we do first for this? We have VAX, but if we are talking about, if we want to find the exact direction of the VA, what should be the exact direction of the VA in this case? The exact direction of the VA can be obtained from the ICZV position, because we know that the line, the ICZV, the line that perpendicular to the velocity, the line that perpendicular to the velocity at any point on a rigid body at this instant, it will cross the ICZV. The line perpendicular to the velocity of the D point have the intersection with the line that perpendicular to the velocity of the B point. And for the A point, now we don't know the direction of the velocity, but we know that the line that perpendicular to the direction of the velocity need to pass through the ICZV. But it seems like it's not that difficult for us. We need to obtain the omega. We need to obtain the omega of the ICZV. Omega of the ICZV. If we want to obtain the omega, we may need to know the length and the magnitude of the velocity at point A, but the information give this. So how can we relate the velocity in the x direction and the magnitude of the velocity? How can we find this angle? How can we find this angle in this case? So this angle should equal to this angle, because this line deviate by this angle from the vertical direction, and this line, the vector, velocity vector at point A, is perpendicular to the line CA. So it should deviate with the same angle from the horizontal direction. And what is this angle? What is this angle now?
อาจารย์ครับ
ครับครับ
could you describe why VA pass ICZV again?
YVA VA, the direction of VA is not passed through the ICZV, but the line that perpendicular to the velocity need to pass through the ICZV point.
Yes, I know that, but when you draw the line, you draw from point B and point D, right?
Okay.
And then why you can assume that we can draw the line from A to C and then it perpendicular to BA?
Okay. Okay, in this diagram, the concept is, if we want to find I C sub V, when we know the velocity vector, the direction of the velocity vector, we can draw the perpendicular line from that vector, and it's gonna cross at one point, and at that point, it's gonna be the IC sub V. And for the other different point, if you want to find the direction of velocity of any point, you can draw the line from the IC sub V to that point, and the velocity vector always perpendicular to that, maybe D, the VD is perpendicular to the line that point from the IC sub V to the point D. I also don't know how to prove this, but yeah, is the way we apply this idea. Actually, this corresponds to the third point. I mean, to locate the IC sub V, we draw a perpendicular line that perpendicular to the two velocity vector. And I see that we will be at the intersection point of the perpendicular line. And when we know the magnitude of the velocity, we can obtain the omega of the rigid body at that time. And here, I just show only VB. That is the point that we already consider. But actually, this one, we can apply it to VA. We can apply it to any possible point on a rigid body. And the magnitude of the velocity will equal to the omega and multiply by the radius or the distance between the two points. In this case, it may be not easy to understand, but I think if you see in this picture, the one special case, I think it can make you understand a little more easier. I mean, if you have the omega, the omega and multiply by CB, omega multiplied by CB. You will get the magnitude of the velocity at point B, right?
Okay.
You use omega multiplied by CA. Yeah. If you have any other point, maybe point D, if you use omega and multiply by that radius, you can get the magnitude of the velocity at point D. But for this, it's a special case that the vector are parallel. But what we are talking here is when the vector are not parallel, but the magnitude of the vector is still can be obtained from the omega multiplied by the radius. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So in this case, you use D and B to determine the IC sub V, and then you use IC sub V to determine the direction of VA, right?
Yes.
So this can be applied to any, like any number of velocity on the rigid body, right?
Yes. Any point. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Okay, but now maybe what you need to help me is how can we obtain this angle? Let me see. wait. Angle. How can we obtain the angle? Let me see. The theta is 30 degree. The theta is 30 degree. And this is 60 degree. 60 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree. And the theta is 30. I saw triangle. Yeah, it's 30 degree, but yeah, it should be 30, but how can I make it clear? Wait a second. We have no. Why I cannot see 30 degree here? We have the theta here, and we have the theta here, and this is also theta. So No. I don't understand. give me more hint. Sorry. Okay. Thank you. Who helped me? Firm, right? We have 100 here, and we have 100 here, and yes, I see. We have 100 and 100. So what can we say? We have the triangle, and sorry everyone, we have the triangle A, B, and C. And the length of BC, the length of BC, we have the triangle. We have the triangle A, B, and C. The length BC, 100 millimeter, is known because we know the right triangle. The length here is 200 and the angle is 30 degree. So we know 100 millimeter. Angle B theta plus 90. Angle B, okay. And the length AB is also 100 millimeter. And And we know that this angle and this angle are equal because we have 100 and 100 millimeter. And this angle plus this angle plus theta. This angle plus this angle and plus 90 degrees. If we consider the triangle ACD, we don't know this angle. The angle in the triangle ACD will be beta plus beta plus beta plus 90 degree and plus 30 degree need to equal to 180 degree. So finally, yes, the beta angle need to equal to 30 degree. Okay, so the beta angle is also 30 degree. Thank you very much for helping. And the beta angle is 30 degree. And I want you to see this one. I want you to see the line CA. The line CA make an angle here with the vertical direction. The line CA made an angle beta with the vertical direction. So the perpendicular to the velocity VA need to make the same angle here with the horizontal direction. So now we can say that the VA in X direction is equal to the magnitude of VA cosine beta. And of course the beta is 30 degree. We may can write like this. So we know that the VAX have the magnitude of 2 meters per second. So in this case, the magnitude of the velocity of point A should be VAX divided by cosine of beta, which means 2 per cosine 30 degree. And VA, the magnitude is 2.309 meter per sec. The omega of the rigid body, is equal to the V of point A divided by the length of the line AC. If you want to find the omega about point C, it needs to be the VA divided by the length of AC, So do you think we can find the length of AC? We know that this is 100 millimeter and we know the angle So the line AC, the length of the line AC is equal to 2 multiplied by 0.1 meter and cosine 30 degree. And the numerical value is 0.1732. So the omega is equal to, the omega is equal to VA divided by 0.1732. And this is omega. And if we want to find the downward velocity, VD, the downward velocity VD is equal to the omega and multiplied by the length CD. Which means omega, the length CD is 0.2 cosine 30 degree. Okay, this is the application of the ICZV. The omega here, is formed from the link ABD. The omega is formed from the link ABD because one point is VD. And we also have the point B. The omega here is the omega of the link ABD because we consider it about the ICZV that obtained from the velocity on the rigid body ABD, one from the D point, one from the B point. And when we solve for the omega, we also use the A point. ABD are the point on the link ABD. So this omega, is related to the angular velocity of the link ABD. So this is just an example when we need to use the ICZV method. So I need your help to recheck to confirm that you understand how to apply the ICZV to solve this and to cross-check an answer. We also can use the relative motion method. For the relative motion method, I just give you a hint, but we are not going to complete it in this class. Remember the governing equation VA equal to VB plus the relative velocity between A and B. But in this case, just only one condition may not enough. You may need to use VD equal to VB plus the relative velocity between D and B. The velocity of the A point, of course, we know that we have in X and in Y direction, we're gonna have VAX and VAY. For the B direction, we have one component and A with respect to B. We have the theta angle, so the A with respect to B, maybe the angle will be something like this, not difficult. And for the D, yeah, direction is just only downward. For VB, direction of VB will be to the right hand side. And D with respect to B, D with respect to B, we also need to find this angle. And you have the magnitude and have the angle, direction, magnitude, and compose the X direction, compose the Y direction, and you will have two equations from this and have two equations from this. And maybe by this, you also can solve for the omega ABD and solve for VD. If you have time, we check the ICZV to obtain the omega and obtain the VD and cross check with the practice using the relative motion method. Okay, it's a long day and sorry for the delay, but that's all for today. Do you have any questions?